three, and a two, and a three, two, one. Whee! Okay. That's enough of that. What's the next step? Build and power the Phoropter prototype. Just give me a second. Huh. Okay. The Phoropter Prototype. Prototype. And I'll link it up to the terminal. And I'll come over here. And subliminal message, fault monitoring, improved eye care. Notes from Dr. Braun. The challenge I put before you is to find a way to turn a simple eye exam into something that furthers Vault-Tec's ambitions. The Phoropter is an excellent delivery mechanism because it's infrequent enough and arcane enough that if anything slightly irregular occurs, no one would know. I expect great things from each of the teams. Improved eye care, vault monitoring, and subliminal messages. Well, in true Vault-Tec fashion, subliminal messages it is. R&D lead notes on subliminal messaging. R&D has designed a series of microflash images which, when played repeatedly and in a loop, have a statistically significant positive effect on the test subject's view of the vault, Vault-Tec, and the overseer specifically. Whenever quite perfected, an eye drop formula that was both effective and didn't cause long-lasting eye trauma. But we're still working on that. Note. The lab had further advantages of electroshock and physical restraints, so your mileage may vary in the field trials. Accept parameters?
Now, we just need a volunteer for the Phoropter.
Mm-hmm. Come on. All right, I'm gonna sit down. It's not that difficult. It's right there.
That power cycle really gets your heart beating. Like, really, really beating.
Let's trade some things.
Never thought no, I'd be an honest-to-goodness vault dweller. Huh.
Yeah?
I'd like to trade some items.
Sure thing.
Looks like we have our first patient. Yes. Before we begin, Clem, how do you feel about children?
They're all right, I guess.
You ever planning on having any?
I don't know. Why are you asking?
Just idle chatter. Go on.
Hi, you here for an eye exam with the this thing?
I guess.
Go ahead and get in.
Do do do.
So deedly, deed, what deed, do deed. I do?
Just stay still.
It keeps flashing.
I think that's normal.
Yeah, that's normal. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
This thing's not working.
What were you doing? I kept saying obey the overseer.
Mm. Well, that's just a quirk of the prototype. Nothing to concern yourself with.
Bullshit. This ain't the end of it.
So strange having people about.
Uh-huh.
Hi.
What the hell is your game? You invite Clem and me in here to experiment on us? You some sort of sicko?
Yes. But it's for the greater good.
Everything we're doing is for the greater good.
You keep telling yourself that. At least up in the Commonwealth, everyone's up front about trying to kill you or rip you off. Come on, Clem. Let's leave. These guys are assholes.
But I've got a job now. I'm an optim... I run the eye machine. I can't leave.
Run while you can, Clem.
Finally, Vault 88's work can truly begin.
Clem got an eye exam machine. Yay! Where are you going? I'm supposed to talk to you.
Hey there.
So, one of our residents left. Well, it'll be easy enough to replace her. The important thing is that our work is progressing admirably.
Well, what is the next job?
What's the next job?
This last experiment is my pride and joy. Following in the footsteps of Dr. Braun and the others, I have spent my time devising my very own prototype. Its premise is this. We are all flawed creatures, each with our own vices. What if our vault didn't pointlessly try to stamp out these predilections and instead harnessed them?
Harness them how?
Give me the details.
The vice in question is greed. The schematic is for a slot machine. I designed it to be as enticing as possible. Choose the experimental parameters and let's see how it fares in the field.
Okay. And you get hooked up. Okay, you get hooked up in a different location. Slot machine prototype. Indentured servitude, customer prof. Profiling, lost revenue. Notes from the overseer Barstow. Whew. Gambling is alluring by its very nature. Debatable. Casinos throughout the country have spent millions to further refine its appeal. In an in-depth analysis of the techniques involved in Commonwealth psychology today, give me inspiration to use gambling as positive motivational force in the vault. How? The big unanswered question is, what's the best way to use this device? Yes, how? Options. First option. The device could manipulate probability, first entice a subject, then later drain them of all financial resources. This would ensure the maximum amount of revenue for the vault. This is the indentured servitude parameter. Second option, the machine itself could be a standard game of chance, but the machine is capable of identifying behavior and allowing the overseer to track those with degenerate behavior, customer profiling. And the third option, if there's time for a control, the probability could be adjusted to maximize the returns, i.e. gamblers will win more often than not. Undoubtedly, this would prove popular and expensive. But the lost revenue parameter should only be chosen for A/B testing. A-B testing. Is that option A-B testing? Okay. I'm gonna go with customer profiling. Accept parameters. Let Clem gamble for an hour. Yep. Okay, Clem, you have fun with that. Or Strong, would you like to gamble? Hmm? I guess not. Well, while he's doing that, I am going to shore up my defenses. Where do I want these? Oh, I don't know where that goes. I don't want to put them there. This lovely cave area down through here should be just fine. Rats coming from. I'll find you, Rads, and when I find you, I'll stop you. There! I stopped you. Done. Should be finished gambling by now, or by the time I get back. Good for you, Clem.
The thing's broke. It keeps making these weird clicking noises.
That's not broke. It's programmed to do that.
Time to check in with the slot machine. I can't wait.
Of course you can. You just did. Yes, it did.
Hey.
Let's check in with Clem.
Oh. Okay, are you gonna walk over there or are you gonna go to your bed?
Every now and again, I swear it makes strange noise and flashes.
You must be imagining things. A slot machine doesn't take pictures of people.
It's time to be sarcastic. What's he gonna say?
Now we just need a variety act and some crime bosses and our casino's set.
Ah, your famous wit. It's done. Finally. Hundreds of years of refining and planning. And you did marvelously. Vault-Tec would be so proud.
Boy, the lady overseer sure is smart. I just feel like everything she says makes sense.
Yes, Clem. Good.
Clem.
You should take another soda break. With my life's work done, I think I will deliver our schematics to other vaults to improve their lives.
Well, why don't you stay as the overseer?
Vault 88 needs you. And your guidance. We can't afford to lose our overseer.
How touching. Sentiment should be
strong dislike that. Of course he does.
It does. I will stay. And together, we will make Vault 88 a beacon of hope for the future.
Legend of Vault 88 reduces damage from ghouls by 15%. Not that I need it.
Strongler, new word. Strongler, respect.
Respect me? That's good.
Respect is a good word.
Strong respect, human. Human fight good. Human help strong. Super mutants are brothers. Brothers share all. Not own things like humans. Humans share like brother. Super mutants fight. Kill, not talk. Human kill, not talk. Human would be good super mutant.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Strong. I respect you too.
Of course. Strong is strong.
Wonderful, Strong. Just wonderful. I think that's done. Now I just need to set a few things down into my... little area and sanctuary, and then I can get on with more questing. Clem's a degenerate gambler. Wonderful. This is gonna take a minute. Good for them.
Yeah?
Nope. Now, let's see. I could start the Far Harbor or the Nuka arcade thingy next. I think I will work on Far Harbor. That'll be next. Alrighty. Well, thank you for watching. I hope you had fun. I know I did. I thank you for watching all the way to the end. And I thank you even more for supporting your favorite idiot, myself, on PayPal or Patreon. Till next time, bye.